the chairman of the committee that will write the tax code to pay for the $829 billion health care bill may be incredibly corrupt himself. But don't go looking for answers from House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. She and Democratic leadership are circling the wagons around Congressman Rangel. In effect, she's backing off her promise for an open and ethical Congress. As House GOP leader John Boehner says, it's not in our nation's best interest to have the chairman of the House's powerful tax writing committee under investigation for running afoul of tax laws. Wouldn't you agree with that, Mr. Mike Papantonio? Mike's a progressive talk radio host. What about it, Mike? The guy's clearly under investigation for tax fraud, yet he writes the tax laws. But man, this sound stinks, smells bad.
I think a good perp walk is always good for democracy. I wish we'd had a perp walk with Tom DeLay. You know, I got to tell you something. This idea of Congress people thinking they're above that perp walk, it does harm to us. Right now, look, right now you have Nancy Pelosi, you have Democrats and Republicans saying that they want to tax people who have these Cadillac policies, that have policies that are upper-end policies because they can't find anybody else to pay for it. Well, you know, that's a credibility problem when the guy saying that is a guy that I agree with you, Eric. I know we don't agree often, but he's a guy that should be under investigation. It's good for democracy.
Mike, it goes so much beyond. I mean, you're sitting there and you're starting to talk health care policy behind the Charlie Rangel stupidity stuff. And let's actually dig into that a little bit. This isn't some sort of a joke, man. I mean, we are sitting here talking about $2 trillion in budgeting and taxes that this guy Rangel is supposed to be helping figure out how to do, and he's a crook.
Exactly. And you know what? Well, look, you know why he's not talking about where the real money should come from? Here's what he knows. He's so tied into the money. Look, here's what he could do. He knows right off the bat that the people that are giving him a lot of the money that he's going to be investigated for are the people who have offshore tax havens, $150 billion a year lost in offshore tax havens. How about this, Cody? How about $450 billion that George Bush gave his millionaire club? Roll that back and you pick that up for health club, for health care. Or how
clawback,
about 160? Exactly,
Mike,
clawback.
That's why,
but you know
that's
what?
Why none of this is going to change, Mike, because it's like they're all so involved. Once you get one little bit of information comes out, boy, it's all going to be tumbling down like a house of cards. That's why you had both Republicans and Democrats not voting to remove him as chairman of that committee, because one day they're going to be under an ethics investigation. You know, I mean, he looks like Charlie Rangel has a lot of problems, and maybe for the good of everyone, he should step aside. And on the other hand, it's like when you're under investigation, you haven't been found guilty yet. You know, I would hate to be put in that situation where you have to lose your job because you're under investigation. But also,
Rebecca, you know
that
what
committee needs to hurry up. It's been going on more than a year.
I agree. Look, you know what good it does? When they start asking questions about people like Rangel, then they start asking questions about people like Mitch McConnell to find out, or Max Baucus. They start asking questions about, where does your money come from? When you go to the floor every day in the committee, when you vote, where does your money come from? And that's the problem. And, you know, Cody, I agree with you when you come back to this theme constantly, and I'm a convert to your idea. It doesn't care whether you're Democrat or Republican. It's both sides of it. You've got to clean up the money. Rangel is the guy that could be a good focus on what is happening to the money. The next guy I'd look at is a guy like Max Baucus and Mitch McConnell. If you don't clear up the money, you don't get meaningful legislation.
Mike, we're going to run out of time real quick, about 30 seconds. So should Rangel just step down? And let's take it one step further. Should he just step down from his whole representative title and just walk away?
I hope he doesn't, because if he does, the same thing happened to Tom DeLay. Tom DeLay, we never got a chance to look at his crookedness. And you know what? You have to look at that crookedness. You need a good perp walk to preserve democracy. If
Mike
it's his perp walk or Tom DeLay,
because then it
you
would just be
it.
A settlement like all the banks.
No,
Mike
exactly.
Papantonio,
we'll never
stay
know.
Prosecute. You can still prosecute.
Listen to Mike Papantonio calling for the head of a Democrat. I love it.
He's a conservative.
The Republican Democrat regime is falling by the wayside in front of your eyes.
He said you converted.
I love it. Thanks for joining us, Mike.